Welcome back, episode 37, back in the shed, and we're going to start off on a sour note. This hunky blew up. It's done 180 something thousand Ks. It's not even 10 years old, it's like 7, 8 years old. Blowing up, it's good for nothing. Might as well push it off a cliff. Anyways, I'm in the shed working on the truck that I have built. By myself. Everything. Every single nut and bolt I've turned by myself. And I guarantee you I'm going to have more success with this than that. So, we're going to start off by pulling the tires off today. Why, you may ask? Well, there's a club run with our club next weekend. And I want to chuck them on a mate's truck and see what they do. So, we're going to do that. So, let me start by stripping the tires off. And it's going to look real stupid on some rolling biscuits. I promise you that. So I've got to say a massive thank you to Raptor Liner New Zealand Australia. Now I had some issues with the colour on my doors versus got my mam just falling off the back of the truck. The colouring on my doors versus the body. Now, as you guys know, I painted them in separate days. The only thing we could put it down to potentially was one day I painted it, the body, it was sunny. And then when I painted the doors, it was like a cold, rainy day. So we've just put it down to who knows what. But Raptor have been epic and they've stepped up and given me enough product to replace the doors, so I've got to respray those. And they're pretty awesome, and they gave me a little bit extra to paint the floor and stuff, which I wasn't planning on doing, so that's pretty awesome of them. So I've got to say a massive thank you to Raptor. For me, when I'm dealing with companies and products, there's two things that determine a good company. One is obviously a good product, and two is people that stand behind their product when there's an issue, because it's life. There is always going to be a product that's going to have an issue. I don't care what you sell. There's no way you can have 100% out of your products forever. So these things happen, and it's awesome to know that companies like Raptor will step up and own the problem. While we're on the subject of Raptor, I really want to give you guys a lesson where I mucked up. It does say in the instructions, right, to make sure that you cover all bare metal, and now obviously you guys saw the videos, I did my best to spray it, but when it dried I noticed there was a couple of tiny little spots that weren't really covered properly in the primer, and I just went, it'll be fine, it's only a little spot. So it will not adhere to bare steel, and what happened was over here there was just a tiny little bit that didn't get primer on it, right? And so that peeled off, and so what I've been doing is trying to chip it off with a screwdriver so I can get it back enough and then feather it out and then reprime it, respray it. Now I wanted to take this time to show you just how tough this Raptor liner is. See, it's scratched it. I'm trying to take it off, it won't come off. So you can normally scratch it and it doesn't wear too badly. Obviously that's me scratching with a sharp screwdriver. So in the bush should be pretty good. But this stuff is seriously impressive. So I must be at the good adhesion patch now, so I can kind of feather that out, prime it, and then when I re-spray it, because obviously I did the bonnet, you can slightly see the variation in colours. You can, so when I sprayed the bonnet, I did it at the same time I did the doors, obviously. So I'm going to redo bonnet, doors, rear door, and then I've still got to finish this stuff and paint this front end, and then and the floor. Then we're done, hopefully, with all the painting and stuff. That's going to look cool when it's all one color. Be very excited for that. So yes, quick tip, if you ever use Raptor liner, please, for your own sake, my sake, everyone's sanity, make sure that you cover all bare metal properly. Now, in case you missed the last time I did this, this is Raptor Black, this is the hardener, and this is filled to about, there's a litre bottle and it's filled to 750. So Raptor have made this really easy, where you get the hardener and you fill it to this line here, and then shake it. So, it's bright, it's really hot, and I haven't even got my overalls on yet, so I've got to get my overalls, what do you call it, respirator, that thing. Once I get that on, then it's glasses and pretty much ready to paint. So do me a favor, don't ever paint this kind of two-pot stuff without a respirator. You can thank me later, but just please don't, seriously. It is dangerous stuff. You don't want to be breathing it into your lungs. And I know you're going to say, oh, if you've got a beard, it doesn't seal properly. Well, for whatever reason, this respirator actually works quite well for me. Even with the beard, it seems to seal. Worst case, you could put Vaseline around here and create a seal, but I don't need to do that. It seals quite well. These are my safety glasses. They're not actually safety glasses, but it's better than nothing. It's bright outside. So, let me get ready, and I'm going to paint these things, as you can see. Prepped, cleaned, wax and grease removed. Everything's ready to rock and roll. I've put etch primer on all the bare spots of metal which got missed last time, and it should be ready to go. So, wish me luck. I'm hoping it's going to come out better than ever, and I really enjoy painting this stuff, so it's fun either way, which is cool. So, let me get dressed. Good to be out of that. So that's all done. What I didn't film was the cleanup. So, basically, I got some two-way thinners there. And so, what I do, I'll quickly show you. You've always got to clean the gun. Like, as soon as you finish, you got to clean the gun. You're supposed to clean the gun in between bottles as well, just so it doesn't block up. So I just get the paint mixer and then just pour the two-way thinners in, and it's got a cut on the angle here, so I just stick it on the angle, tilt it over, spray it all in a safe space until it comes out nice and clear, and then I dip a rag in and wipe all the rest of it down. As you can see, it's relatively clean, so make sure you do that. But yeah, it looks like it's come out all right. I might have stuffed up the bonnet when I sprayed it. It looks a little bit stripy, so I'm hoping it dries a bit better, but worst case, I can just put another coat on top. It's really hot out here, so that's going to dry quite quickly, which would be good. Right, so it's stinking hot out here. The other thing I forgot to mention before is wear your gloves. Nice, they're like a swimming pool on the inside. It is disgusting. It really is disgusting. So yeah, let me get undressed and cool off a little bit. I'll be back in a sec. Time to cool off. As I mentioned at the end of last year, we're going to change things up for 2019. And our plans are to make the episodes better, the build vlogs, everything. Going to try our best to make it more interesting for you guys to watch, because you guys love them. So we're going to put in a bit more effort with them, which is going to be interesting. Shay's going to come down and help me film some things. Normally I just film it and edit it by myself. She's also going to give me a hand with some editing. Now that brings me to the thing, every Monday I try and put out a video. We're going to change that to Tuesdays, which is going to work better for us. So, I hope you guys are alright with that. If not, we'll see you on Tuesday when you decide to watch. So this weekend, I managed to finish off the driver's seat mount, so that's completely done. The seat's in, installed, ready to go, nice and strong. I've braced it, sort of, and spread the load as much as I could, which is cool. As you guys saw, I then went to repaint the doors and stuff because I had that issue with colour, which is cool. That's all painted and it looks like it's come out alright. I'm going to have to see what that bonnet looks like. A little bit stripy for my liking, but we'll see. With some mud on it, you'll never notice. And so, yeah, it's coming along nicely, to be honest. I'm feeling quite positive about where the truck's heading. Obviously we're going to King of the Hammers. We fly out in like 2 weeks, so that's going to be crazy. I'm going to try and get as much done as I can, but I'm also going to try and film a bunch of stuff at King of the Hammers for you guys to watch instead of a video. I don't know how much reception we'll have to upload while we're on the lake bed, but I do encourage you guys to watch King of the Hammers live. It's going to be awesome, and their live show is incredible. They do put on a very, very good live show. Definitely worth the watch. Now some of you guys have asked, it's on their website, ultra4racing.com. It's always a live link. YouTube, there's always a live link, and Facebook, there is always a live link, and no doubt we will try our best to post the live link on our Facebook and Instagram as well for you guys. So check that out if you got nothing to do. It's a good excuse to sit around and barbecue and drink some beers with friends and not drive and just hang out and watch TV all day. It's pretty cool. Other changes that are coming in 2019, you guys that watch these videos get all the good secrets. So we're changing our format completely for the episodes. Before, there were a 21 minute episode based around TV. For 2019, we've decided to ditch that and we're going to go down to like 5 or 6 minute episode of just good quality shots, more cinematic stuff. We're still going to have interviews, we're still going to have all that other stuff that we had in the episodes before. We're just going to cut them down and make them look better. So watch out for those. Those are coming soon. We're just trying to get through the last of our season 4 episodes, which are taking a little bit longer than expected. So as usual, I'm going to carry on, and you guys are fantastic. Thank you again for watching. I love reading all your comments, and it makes me feel much better about building this truck, because it's not the easiest task in the world, but it is fun, has its ups and downs, and it's going to be epic when it runs. And it's getting closer and closer. So, we'll see you guys next week on Tuesday.